LQ four cylinder heads. These are 317 castings on a 6 liter Chevy LS. This is going to be a boosted application. So I've polished the combustion chambers partly to remove a nasty ridge that the machine shop left in cutting the valve seats for me. And I figured I'm there, I might as well polish the combustion chambers. Theoretically, polishing the combustion chambers reduces all of the hot spots or potential sources for pre-ignition and detonation. It can also keep the more of the heat in combustion and into the exhaust and hopefully increase the spool of the turbo a bit better. But mainly I just did it to avoid detonation because I'm using cast pistons with an LS. And I know the LS motors can handle a ton. I want this to handle quite a bit for a long time. So I polished them. But the risk of polishing the combustion chambers is you lose some of the combustion chamber volume. It gets bigger. So I'm checking these to make sure they're not stupid. So you saw me put a smear of Vaseline around the spark plug threads and a smear around the valve seats. And then I just set the phase of the valves in. They're not sprung or anything. They're just sitting in there. So moving the spark plug over, snug it up. Then a little bit of Vaseline on the valves. There they go. Goop it around the outside, around the outside, around the outside. And I didn't want any excess because that'll give me a false reading. I've got a piece of plexiglass. It probably has a hole about 3/16 diameter and countersunk on one side. I went to the science department and said, have you got like one of these measuring things, a barrette? They said, yeah, I think it's a barrette. Anyways, it measures cubic centimeters, cc's, milliliters. And they had only up to 50 cc's, and these heads are supposed to be 71. So, well, it's free and I borrowed it. So I would fill it up to 50 and then add in another 50 and then just add the numbers together. And this cylinder head was measuring about 73.3, 73.2 all the way across. These heads are supposed to be 71 cc's. So anyways, but the plexiglass helps seal and helps you see what's going on inside. You got to try to get rid of all the air bubbles. The Vaseline helps seal all the goop in. Some guys use mineral spirits or paint thinner or solvents or whatever. I'm using washer fluid. It's part alcohol and it's part water. I have it. And I figured the cleanup will be easier than getting solvent all over the place. So that's what I'm using. May not be the best. I don't think it matters. Depends how fussy you want to get. All of these combustion chambers, I had to tweak a couple. I got them within about 1% of each other, but I may muck with them a little bit more and try to get them a little bit more precise. One head is averaging like the mid 72s, like 72 and a half. The other one is the very low 73s. Alternatively, I could just have the heads milled a little bit more. It depends how fussy I want to get for really what is a street vehicle that isn't going to ever see any track time. This whole head took me about 30 minutes. This is sped up 8 times and brought it down to 4 minutes and 10 seconds. So, but it's going along pretty good. A couple of the chambers I've just kind of sneezed a little bit of scuffing in there, but once I'm going to give up and call it done, depends how fussy you want to be. You can get them all exact, you'll spend forever doing this, and I don't think I'm going to notice it in driving. However, one way to look at it is if you have one chamber that's a little bit smaller than the rest, that might be the chamber that destroys your motor because it's the one that's going to be knocking first. Or maybe it knocks and you don't notice, and then you take out other parts of the motor. I don't know. I'm not going to make this a complete ludicrous motor. You know, 15, 18 pounds of boost. Sure. Anyways, it went all right. That's okay. Cleaning it all up. Call her done.